What's good, Shalom? We out here another day. All praises. Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles of GMS, you know what I mean? But we out here in downtown Columbus. Here you go. You need to raise this up. There you go. You got something you want to read?
No.
I was about to say get 1 Samuel 22. We're going to read the whole chapter.
1 Samuel 22. It's
1 Samuel. Oh, yeah, but before we start, yeah, today is 9/11. It's an, was it a 15th anniversary of 9/11? And these people still asleep. They still don't know what the hell is going on. You still got people believing Al-Qaeda blew up the Twin Towers. Dumbass people. Go ahead.
David therefore departed thence and escaped to the cave of Adullam. And when his brethren...
Now, where you at?
1 Samuel 22.
You sure it's 22?
1 Samuel? Sure it's 2 Samuel?
Hold up. 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel.
What did I say?
2 Samuel. 1 Samuel.
Maybe the 2 Samuel. No, I thought it was 1 Samuel. Maybe it's 24.
Ah. They didn't have the chance to kill Saul. That's version.
No, that's not it.
Really about
the Song of David. Yeah, I was just reading it. Maybe the. Oh, bro.
Second Samuel 22 and 1. And David spake unto Yahweh the words of this song in the day that the Yahweh have delivered out of the hand of all his enemies, and out of the hand of Saul. And he said, Yahweh is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer.
Yeah, y'all know, God's name is not Lord. Alright, so every time when you read the Bible and it says Lord in all capital letters, when you look it up in the original Hebrew text, the word there is Yahweh, which is the name of the Most High. Okay, the Most High God, because God's name is not God. The word Lord and the word God is nowhere to be found in the original text. Okay, those are English words. So yeah, go ahead, read that again, just so they get, because you know a lot of people still don't know that.
And he said, Yahweh is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. The God of my rock, in him will I trust. He is my shield and the horn of my salvation, my high tower and my refuge, my savior. Thou savest me from violence. I will call on Yahweh, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. When the waves of death compassed me, the floods of ungodly men made me afraid.
Right, because you got floods of ungodly men out here. That's all you see is floods of them. And it didn't just say there was like just a couple ungodly men. There's floods of them. We surrounded by them right now. We can pass about on all sides by ungodly men. You know what I mean? Just a bunch of serpents and vipers ready to bite your ass. Go ahead.
The sorrows of hell can pass me about. The snares of death prevented me. In my distress, I called upon Yahweh.
Yeah, because this right here is the sorrows of hell. Living in America, that's the sorrows of hell. Being around all these retarded people, that's being in hell. Being around all these wicked people with no knowledge. Living in a land where there's no knowledge, you know? We in hell right now. Okay, go ahead.
In my distress, I called upon Yahweh and cried to my God, and he did hear my voice out of his temple and made my cry. My cry did enter into his ears. Then the earth shook and trembled. The foundation of heaven shook.
Hold a second. We're going to get back to that in a second. What is it? Abba Yori right there. This is our girl. Shalom. I don't know where to set up. It's all the spots that took it today.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, we can just stay right up in the middle, huh? Here, I'll just put the camera over here. We can scoot over a little bit. It don't matter. Don't nobody be walking through here, no way. Oh, that's true.
Mind of the little goons.
We can go down to the far end if you want. Go down there? All the way down there, right where that woman's at? You know what I mean? Just at the end of the gate, the fence. We just wait for somebody to leave, though. And we was just talking about right when we came up. I heard everybody said it. Hey, they still believe the government story of 9/11. They think ISIS is real, and they praising Obama because Obama caught Osama bin Laden. And they believe that. Here it is, Obama said he caught Osama bin Laden. And then they said they took his body and dumped it in the ocean. And people believed it, bro. How stupid can you be to believe that? Like, why would they take his body, the most wanted man in the world, and then they gonna take all proof of them capturing him and dumping him in the ocean? Because you know that never happened. Only a retard would believe that. Yeah, I just put him up against the fence, but they ain't gonna be nowhere for the walk. You ain't gotta put him up. What bus had the SPD sign?
I said, you can't get hit hard with that super kind of wheel, bro. I mean, it said super kind of wheel. The super kind of wheel.
Yeah, we just put them up. There ain't no wind today. That makes it easier for people to read them anyway. Oh shit, I forgot about that. Can't forget that. Yeah, you put him where so he gets stuck on it. They were wearing a little boys last week and kicked the hell out of him. But that one kid's name, his name was Isaiah, he just kept stabbing him in the head. I get you a Bible. And we was reading the Psalm of David. Hey, get back to me. You still on that? Read back where you at. Started at 6 again.
2 Samuel 22 and 6. Sorrows of hell can pass me about. The stairs of death prevented me.
Right, the sorrows of hell is this. Like I said, we living in hell out here. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Distress, I called upon Yahweh, and he cried to my God, and he did hear my voice out of the temple, and my cry did enter into his ears. Then the earth shook and trembled.
Then the earth shook and trembled. Go ahead.
The foundations of heaven moved and shook because he was wroth.
Yeah, so the Most High is wroth, man. He's angry. The Most High is pissed off. And soon he's going to bring that fire on this earth. And the earth is, I mean, America's going to be destroyed by fire. And like Isaiah says, the earth is going to, the destruction is going to be so great that the earth is going to rock to and fro like a drunkard, like a drunk man. Go ahead.
There went up smoke out of the nostrils, fire out of the mouth of God. Coals were kindled by it. He bowed the heavens also and came down, and darkness under his feet.
What does that mean? He bowed the heavens and came down. So that's the Lord's chariot. He's going to come down out of the sky. Just like when you read the New Testament, it tells you that when Yahweh Shai comes back, he's going to come out the clouds with legions of angels. It says, behold, he cometh with clouds. Every eye shall see him.
Go ahead.
He rode upon a cherub and did fly. And
he rode upon a cherub and did fly.
He was seen among, he was seen upon the wings of the wind. And he made darkness and rebellions round about him, dark waters and thick clouds in the skies. Through the brightness before him was cold as fire kindled. How would thunder from heaven and the Most High uttered his voice? And he sent out arrows and scattered them, lightning and discomfort them, and the channels of the sea departed. The foundation of the world was discovered at the rebuking of Yahweh, at the blast of the breath of his nostrils.
All right, hold on a second. Yeah, so it tells you that the Lord's coming out the clouds in his chariot. He said he's right up on the cherub. That's that chariot, the so-called UFOs. That's the Lord. Going all the way back to the Exodus. Even during the Exodus, the Lord was guiding Israel through the wilderness with a so-called UFO. The Bible called it a pillar of cloud by day, a cloud by day, and a pillar of fire by night. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
He sent from above, he took me, he drew me out of many waters, he delivered me from my strong enemy and from them that hated me.
Yeah, because our enemy's strong and they hate us. So you fight against this devil, we fighting against a devil that you can't defeat with weapons. You know what I mean? Because we ain't got no weapons. How you going to fight this devil, bro? But you going to shoot at him with a 9mm? He's coming at you with tanks, drones. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead. The weapons of our warfare is this word. Go ahead.
Well, they were too strong for me. They prevented me in the day of my calamity, but Yahweh was with me still. With my stay, he brought me forth into a large place and delivered me because he delighted in me. Yahweh rewarded me according to my righteousness, according to the cleanness of my hands, that he recompensed me.
Yeah, the cleanness of your hands. That's why we out here cleaning our hands. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
For I have kept the ways of Yahweh and have not wickedly departed from my God, for all his judgments were before me. And as for his statutes, I did not depart from them.
But you got a lot of people that did depart from the Lord's statutes. They once knew him. They was once out here doing the work with us. Now where they at now? Go ahead.
Back in the world.
I was also upright before him and have kept myself from mine iniquity. Therefore, Yahweh have recompensed me according to my righteousness, according to my cleanness in his eyesight. With the merciful, thou wilt show thyself merciful. The upright man, thou wilt show thyself upright. With the poor here, thou wilt show thyself pure. And with the poor, thou wilt show thyself unsavory. And the afflicted people, thou wilt say. But thine eyes are upon the haughty, that thou mayest bring them down.
The haughty. You should look that word haughty up. Haughty. Like these women is haughty, you know what I'm saying? I'm about to look that up. And then nobody use no words like that no more.
Things up.
What is it?
Use words like non-saying.
Non-saying? Yeah, dog. They say dough. They don't say though. They say dough. What's up, dough?
Okay,
what's up, bitch? You bitches. Motherfucker, dough.
Gotta put this to rest.
Oh, shit. Fuck it.
Probably got to
arrogant. There you go.
When you're 40, you have a big attitude.
Hey, put that on camera. Can you start it over?
Yeah, hold up.
40 people are disdainful, overbearing, prideful, swaggering.
That sounds hilarious.
Okay, Google now. Look up the word haughty.
According to vocabulary.com, 40, someone who is haughty is arrogant and full of pride. When you're haughty, you have a big attitude and act like you're better than other people.
A haughty person acts
superior and looks down on others. Haughty people are disdainful, overbearing, prideful, swaggering, and obnoxious.
Obnoxious. The first thing that comes to your mind is the women. They walk around all proud. They got that proud, arrogant spirit. Like they better than everybody. But really, you're just a piece of nothing. You're a worm.
Like this shit don't stink. Once they open their legs, all you smell is a rat.
You gotta call the CDC.
Right.
To try to contain that shit.
I found the CDC here in Columbus too. They just built it.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
That's probably a dangerous place actually.
Brand new place.
Did you know they probably got all kind of viruses in
there?
Oh
yeah, check it out. I found out they why are they doing inoculations for dogs and cats? You know?
Really?
Yeah. How I found it was I was ran into this white woman with the park walking dog. You know, she was talking to me. She just started telling me. She told me how she rescued her dog and she went and got it inoculated at the CDC because it was cheap and free. You know?
Yeah.
So why are the CDC inoculating dogs and cats? You know about the CDC.
Yeah.
That's a good way to spread shit, you know?
The CDC has the Ebola virus, they got the Black Plague. They got everything just ready to go.
Sitting on the stove, huh? The center of disease control. Control. So they can release it, they can control it. It's the devil's eye.
Just like they told you that swine flu, that was manufactured by the government. There's even reports of them spraying us with swine flu with the chemtrails.
That's crazy.
They've been spraying for mosquitoes for the past month.
Yeah, different sides of town. Yeah.
They was doing it on the bottoms last week. They was doing it right in the daytime, just spraying the hell out.
They
was
be out breathing. Like,
they was going through people's yards.
Right. What?
Yeah. Well, you know. Yeah, America's finished. Y'all know that according to the prophecies in the Bible, America's going to be destroyed by fire. If you ain't right, you're going to get burned up. Your flesh is going to melt. Your eyeballs are going to consume away in your sockets.
We're going to get up and move to a new seat.
That's real shit, though. Real shit.
It really is. We are the realest out there.
It was a... top of one of these buildings.
Really?
You know, acting like they was in the 9/11. Children shit. Walking the stairs all the way up these motherfuckers, man. And it was from like 8 a.m. to 12 p.m., man, today.
Yeah, I be seeing a bunch of stupid assholes too all over the internet talking about we need to give thanks to our soldiers that went and protected us from the Muslims on 9/11. And man, these motherfuckers, they said that the Saudi Arabians attacked the United States. So they went instead of attacking Saudi Arabia, they attacked Afghanistan and Iraq. That didn't make no sense.
Vaporized them.
Yeah, and just totally destroyed them. When the truth of this matter, they was in Afghanistan because Afghanistan's got the best poppy plants in the world. Why do you think there's so much heroin in Columbus right now? That's because the United States military is growing poppies in Afghanistan and shipping it over here.
And being protected by soldiers.
Yeah, protected by the Marines. You can get on the Google, type in Marines guarding poppy fields in Afghanistan. That's why, especially over there on the bottoms, I mean, that heroin is everywhere now. And it's all being shipped in by the government because they want to keep you asleep. They want to keep you doped up and retarded. And if you busy chasing drugs and chasing that high, you ain't never gonna, you know, make a difference. You ain't never gonna do nothing. You just gonna sit around high out your fucking mind. You know what I mean? Dumb as hell, not knowing what's going on. Hey, same with the weed too. You see some of that weed they got lately? That's a super powerful weed they got these days. And everybody be gone, you know, smoking blunts all day. They walk around in dazed and confused, don't know what's going on. Yeah, that's another drug, yeah, drug for the mind. That's part of that witchcraft is the rap music. They don't know that, you know, a lot of this music that's being put out by the music industry is made by witches and warlocks, Freemasons.
What you got?
You got more than that sandwich? We can get all that sandwich.
Damn, there's 1,000 pictures, man.
What is that?
the soldiers protecting the poppy fields in Afghanistan.
Oh yeah. That shit goes on for days.
That's a lot of photos, man. Oh, troops in Afghanistan protecting our freedom here at home. Oh wait, that's a poppy field. Never mind. That's what it's. Ooh shit.
You didn't see that shit on there? Probably not. It's too bright out. Man, just get on Google. You're on a computer, look that shit up, man. There's a famous video with Geraldo Rivera on Fox News. And he was over in Afghanistan asking why the hell are they guarding poppy fields? You know?
Damn.
It goes on for days. And heroin, that's on the rise, too, you know? But that's good, though. You know, that's good they're bringing in that heroin. Because, you know, the best thing a lot of y'all can do is just shoot it up and just fucking die. You know what I mean? That's the best thing you could do. Worthless anyway. What's the point? They believe anything. Because anything that TV told them, you know, they believe it. I can't believe motherfuckers are still getting news from the TV. That's crazy. Especially a lot of these old motherfuckers. These old people from the older generation still don't know how to use the internet. You know they dumb when it comes to technology, right? And they still getting all their news from the TV, and they believe everything CNN says. And they just gone. Like the baby boomer generation, they totally gone. They the most brainwashed of them all. They don't know what's going on. They ain't got a fucking clue. Dumb as hell.
Proverbs, this is Proverbs 14 and 15. The simple believeth every word, but the prudent man looketh well to his goal.
Right, the simple believeth every word. So y'all be watching the news, and they tell you that Obama killed Osama bin Laden and dumped him in the ocean, and y'all so stupid you believed it. They told you that Osama bin Laden was behind 9/11, and y'all so dumb you believed it. Here it is. And people, you ask people a question about 9/11, ask them how many buildings got knocked down. They'll tell you two. And they don't know. They're dumb. They're uninformed. And they don't know nothing. That's our people. They ain't got a clue about what's going on. Nothing. I bet you they know about who's in first place in the AFC. I bet you they know who's first place in the Big Ten. You know what I'm saying? I bet you they know who's in the running for the Heisman. They know that. Bunch of dumbass people. Go ahead.
A wise man fears and departeth from evil, but the fool raging is confident. He that is soon angry dealeth foolishly, and a man of wicked devices is hate. The simple inherit folly, but the prudent is crowned with knowledge.
Yeah, the prudent, we crowned with knowledge. So we know what's going on. You ain't gonna deceive us. Okay? Like when they start implementing that mark of the beast in the microchip, we gonna know now to take that. Because we have the knowledge. We know what's going on. When the economy collapses, we know what's going on. We're not going to the safe zone. And they tell you everybody needs to come to the safe zone.
Safe zone.
You know what I mean? Like in Hurricane Katrina. In Hurricane Katrina, the government said, look, we got the safe zone set up in what's the name of that dome? Where the Saints play?
In New Orleans, yeah. Right.
To the football stadium. The Silver Dome.
Something like that, yeah.
And they told everybody to go in there. People went there, they was getting robbed. Women was getting raped.
Children getting chipped.
Yeah. Because these people, they gone, bro.
These motherfuckers is on roofs. Calling for the motherfuckers.
Yeah. But if something like that happens, I'll be rejoicing. Like, finally.
Right. Here you go. This is Matthew 24:24. For there shall rise false Christ and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect.
Right, because we ain't going to be deceived. The elect ain't going to be deceived. Because this devil's he's called a devil for a reason. He's called that old serpent for a reason. He's very tricky. What's that word?
Slithery and slimy.
He's very subtile, okay? He's very slick with his shit.
Behold, I have told you before, wherefore if they shall say unto you, behold, he is in the desert, go not forth.
Yeah,
behold.
Don't listen.
Behold, he is in the secret chambers. Believe it not. For as the lightning coming down the east and shining unto the west.
Yeah, and you always got some whack job claiming to be the Messiah, right?
Right.
There's always some whacked out religious cult popping up out the cut.
Yeah, you got some whacked out motherfucker calling himself the comfort.
Oh, yeah. And you got people following him. You got false messiahs, you got false prophets. Like Nathaniel. They be coming out here, them dudes come out here wearing purple. They set up by the government. Go ahead. And that's why ever since we've been coming out here on a regular basis, we ain't seen them Nathaniel's people out here. IUIC. At first we was seeing them every week. But we kept coming out here. Now, they ain't nowhere to be found, bro. Now, Lord willing, they come out here, we can curse them out again. Go ahead.
Hey, Jeremiah 15:7-11. It says, Yahweh said, verily it shall be well with thy remnant. Verily I will cause the enemy to entreat thee well in the time of evil, in the time of affliction. Now, I got that word entreat. The word entreat means ask someone earnestly to do something.
Entreat.
Yep.
Verily, I will cause the enemy to entreat thee well in the time of evil.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because...
It's vaccinations.
Yeah. I mean, because they'll tell you, you got to get the vaccinations to protect the children. They always use children as an excuse to do something to you. Oh, we got to put microchips in everybody, because that's going to protect your children. If your child gets lost, that microchip will help us find them. You know, we just link them up to the GPS.
On the safe, piece of safety.
Yep.
Trusted in Egypt, man.
Stupid. Revelation 12:9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil, Satan.
Now this right here, that every time during the book of Revelation, you see the word Satan and the dragon and the serpent in the book of Revelation. We're dealing with Revelation only. Every time you see Satan, it's talking about the Roman Empire, which is America's the reincarnation of the Roman Empire, okay? Right. Which is the kingdom of the Edomites. Go ahead, so read that again. They're really talking about Esau. Because why? It's called that great red dragon. Because Esau's red. All right, go ahead.
Revelation 12:9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent.
Oh, yeah, what does a great dragon do? A dragon stomps, kills, and destroys everything in its path. That's what America does. Go ahead.
Called the devil. Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out.
Did not America deceive the whole world? They deceived the whole world with that 9/11 shit. Because they're, you know, they had the, what is that? We can look up the NATO. There's a clause in NATO where a certain thing they can enact, and it was only been done one time, which was after 9/11, which called, in NATO, they have a deal. If any country in NATO is attacked, all the NATO allies must support the member of NATO that was attacked. And on 9/11, they enacted that clause, you know, in their NATO deal, whatever. And all those, that America deceived the whole earth. And the whole earth was thrown into that Afghanistan-Iraq war.
You know what I'm saying?
America
Oh, hell no. You already know that. Unless there's something to be gained out of it. Unless there's some oil, some gold. Some slavery involved, you know. Because you always hear politicians talking about what? Or president saying it's not in America's interests. We have to look out for our interests. It's all about money, man, power, control. Go ahead.
This is 1 Thessalonians 5:2. For yourself know perfectly that the day of the Lord shall cometh as a thief in the night.
Right, so the Lord's going to return when y'all ain't even ready for it, man. y'all out here lollygagging, having a good time, you know, just being asleep, out here being wicked as hell. Okay, the Lord's going to come back soon. Don't get caught sleeping either. Go ahead.
For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them.
So, right, so y'all going to be out there having a good time, having your little orgies, you know what I'm saying, committing adultery. Right, and why you committing adultery, having sex with your neighbor's wife while he's gone to work, that's when you're going to be destroyed. Because the Lord, you're going to think you got away, everything is good. You know, and no, everything's not good. You're going to be destroyed. Go ahead.
As travail from the coming of the child, they shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not in the darkness, but that day should overtake you like a thief. Ye are all the children of light.
What's the difference between y'all, the other guys, the Israelite guys, and the guys in purple?
The guys in purple, the leader is the detective for the NYPD. So they pretty much set up by the government. They're a government-ran church under a 501c3 tax-exempt status.
What about the Israelites of Justin White?
Huh?
What about the Israelites of Justin White?
Well, their leader says he's the comforter. He's the God-sent comforter that's written about in John 14. He said he's the Holy Spirit in the flesh. So them dudes are they're a joke, bro.
So when being under that 501c3, they can't teach.
They can't teach the mark of the beast.
Right. Key things in the Bible they can't teach.
He's a cop. How is that compatible with the scripture? He's upholding the laws of Satan's kingdom. You know what I mean? Getting people tickets. Oh, that dude Nathaniel in charge of the purple people, he got caught setting two brothers up for a crime they didn't even commit. And they did time. And they sued the state of New York and they won. What a city in New York, excuse me.
It's the leader of their camp.
They sued and they won. It was in the news. His name was in the paper and everything.
And the Bible refers to them as dumb dogs. You got a dog that can't warn you and don't bark, man, then that's a worthless dog, right?
Yeah, they worthless.
You know? That you thief coming in your back door, coming through your back window or back door, whatever. Dog ain't barking, it's a worthless dog. He's worthless. And that's the same thing with those fools in purple and red. They ain't barking at all, man. You know, when all hell and calamity is about to hit on people, you know? I mean, all hell is about to hit our people.
To them, it's just really, it's all about the cheddar. You know what I mean? Because you see them garments they got? Them garments ain't cheap. And they got to buy them from the leader. And you best believe he's making a profit off of it. You know what I'm saying?
He's making millions.
And they said his name is Jesus Christ. His name ain't Jesus.
Yeah, his name ain't Jesus Christ. That's not his name.
Say you can call him whatever you want.
If we call him, actually, because the Lord's name is Yahweh Shai. And they actually make fun of us for calling on the Lord's Hebrew name. So them dudes, they're the devil, bro. You should stay far away from them. Actually, you see, you should curse them out and tell them the Lord's going to destroy them.
Isaiah 56 and 9. All ye beasts of the field come to devour, yea, all ye beasts of the forest. His watchmen are blind. They are all ignorant. They're all dumb dogs.
Ignorant means lack of knowledge.
And they ain't got no knowledge. All them dudes they got, they're zombies, bro. And none of them have their own mind. They just like control robots. You know how you've seen them crazy religious cults, right? This ain't it. We are dealing with knowledge and truth. Them dudes, they do whatever their master tells them, bro. He's got full control of their minds. You know what I mean? They're under a spell.
They cannot bark. Sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. Yea, they are greedy dogs which can never have enough. And they are shepherds that cannot understand. They all look to their own way, every one for his gain from his quarter. Come ye, say they, I will fetch wine. We will fill ourselves with strong drink.
That's self-explanatory, how all they doing is out here. Their work is for profit. Their work is for manna, man.
You know?
Never out here teaching the truth. Right, never out here on a consistent basis teaching the truth like it's supposed to be. Because in the scripture, it's supposed to be on the highways and the byways. Consistently, you know, in season and out of season. But not them. Like I said, if it's not profitable, you ain't going to see them.
If it's cold outside, they definitely ain't going to be out here.
Right. We coming on that season now. They're going to really shut it.
Yeah, watching the wintertime, you ain't going to see them. But we'll be out here. I got a precept for you, bro. This is Titus. Titus 1 and 10. For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision, meaning people who know they Israelites like us, but you got other people who teach about Israel, but they're deceivers. It said whose mouths must be stopped, who subvert whole houses, teaching things which they ought not for filthy lucre's sake. And that means, you know, for money. They teach for, they just getting that money, man. That, they make fun of us because they like, y'all look like bums with your bummy garments. They don't make videos about us, you know? This is a joke, bro. Because they make fun of us, for our parents, when the scriptures say, hey, let's get that James with the gay clothing. I think my James is messed up. What is that, James? You know what that's at, bro.
James 2 and 2. And there come unto your assembly a man with gold ring and a goodly apparel, and there come also a poor man in a vile remnant, and he had respect to him that weareth the gay clothing, and saying to him, sit thou here in a good place, and say to the poor, stand down there, or sit here under my footstool.
You're right, because they made videos making fun of our garments. Just like these churches, you go in these churches, if you go up in one of these churches, all dirty looking and stuff, not wearing your Sunday's best, they might throw you out or say something to you. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
And ye then return in yourselves and are become judges of evil thoughts. Hearken, my beloved brethren, have not God chosen the poor of this world rich in faith?
Right, we ain't got money to be buying $1,000 garments, you know what I mean? Go ahead.
And heirs of the kingdom, which he hath promised to them that love him, and he hath despised the poor, do not rich men oppress you, and draw you before the judgment seat. Do not they blaspheme that worthy name?
Do they not blaspheme the name? The IUIC guys, they blaspheme the name of Yahweh Shad. Then they say the Lord's name is Jesus Christ. When that's Greek, the Lord didn't speak Greek, he spoke Hebrew.
You know what I mean? By the which you are called. That's
it. Here you go. This is Matthew 11 and 7. And as they departed, Yahweh Shai began to say unto the multitudes concerning John, what went ye out into the wilderness to see?
Oh, this is talking about John the Baptist. And that the Lord was speaking about. He said, what'd you go out in the wilderness to see? Talking about John the Baptist. Go ahead.
And reed shaken with the wind. But what went ye out for to see? A man clothed in soft raiment? Behold, soft, they that wear...
Yeah, soft raiment means, you know, nice clothes. You know, you see them preachers. The preachers be wearing a Versace suit. They got Rolexes, diamond earrings. You know what I'm saying?
Man, just check out how Creflo Dollar and...
Driving Escalades.
Jesse Jackass and Farrakhan. Look at how they dress, man.
All the prominent leaders dress like that. You know, they looking smooth. Got that fresh shave. You know, just nice and smooth. Face shining.
You supposed to be shaved.
You ain't supposed to shave your beard off.
A man clothed in soft raiment, behold, they that wear soft clothing are in king's houses.
Yeah, they that wear soft clothing are in king's houses.
But what went ye out for to see? A prophet? Yea, I say unto you, and more than a prophet, for this is he of whom it is written, behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee.
Yeah, talking about, because John the Baptist was prophesied in the book of Malachi. Hey, we should get that. That goes into that, you know, explaining. You know, Malachi, what was that for, right? It started to stop, Well, yeah, the last chapter. They started to work. Yeah, read aloud too.
Behold, the day coming that shall burn as an oven all the proud, yea.
Yeah, so this is talking about the end of days, the last days. We in the last days now. It said, behold, the day cometh that will burn like an oven. Go ahead.
All that do wickedly shall be stubble. In the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. But to you, that fear my name, shall the Son of Righteousness arise and fill your wings.
It said, they're to fear my name. And Nathaniel, he even blasphemed the name of the Most High. His one of his dudes said, you can call the Most High whatever you want. He said, you can call the Most High your fight, your. They got it on video saying that. got it on video.
And here for the world to see when he was making fun of the name.
He's got that video saying, any man I've ever heard calling on your house, boss of your house, I was wicked. Okay. He got a video multiple times saying that. Blasphemy in the name of the Lord. That's funny how Nathaniel, every time we come out here, some people ask us about them guys. About, what about those guys in the purple? The dudes is gone. Go ahead.
Yeah, because those things turn a lot of Israelites away from the truth.
Yep. Because they ain't doing it right.
Because first of all Israel ain't going to look the same. Some Israel going to look like white dudes, you know?
Oh, yeah. Because if you're a white dude, they'll be like, you going into slavery.
You a Jake. I can tell just by your eyes, man.
That's what some white dude was standing in front of when they started saying all that shit.
Why?
Wow. Oh, yeah. Say, them dudes ain't spiritual, man. We come out here spiritual.
Right.
We judge people by their spirit, you know what I mean?
They don't know the scriptures then. They don't know, they can't break it down why, what it means by being scattered, how the Lord scattered Israel amongst other nations.
Yep.
They don't understand that.
Yeah, we can go straight to that. Spirit changing. Because that's really the main message in the scriptures. The Lord said, go teach the gospel to all nations. Why did he say that? Because our people got scattered among the entire earth. You know what I'm saying? Because getting thrown into captivity. Back in the ancient world, Israelites got hauled off to Babylon. You know?
Daniel 9:7. O Lord, righteousness belongeth unto thee, but unto us confusion of faces.
Confusion of faces. Because you can't just say, dog, this dude, he's the same color skin as me, so that means we're brothers. That's a simplistic way of thinking, you know what I mean? Only a retard thinks like that. Only reason I know someone's my brother or not is if they follow this, you know what I'm saying? That's all that matters. If they believe in this with all their heart, that's all I need. I don't give a fuck what they look like. Go ahead.
As at this day, to the men of Judah and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to all Israel that are near and that are far off, to all the countries whither thou hast driven them because of the trespass that they have trespassed against thee.
Right, because the Lord scattered our people among all the nations of the earth. I don't care where you go on the planet earth, you can go to a remote village in the Pacific Ocean, and there's gonna be Israelites up in that little village.
Yeah, we made it there somehow.
And he'll probably be the one running shit, you know what I mean?
Right, the president.
He hit the most popular guy.
Yeah, yeah.
Fucking all the women. Kids. Yeah, he got the most kids, right.
Right.
A lot of people love, you know, they love women.
Yeah.
Them heathen nations don't be half pumping out babies like us, boy. Half the damn Chinese are Israelites. You know Bruce Lee, right? You know Bruce Lee's an Israelite.
Oh, yeah.
Look at his spirit. He don't have that regular chink spirit. You see what I'm saying? You gotta look at people's spirit, and you see that fire and that flame in the spirit. And you can see that it's that Israelite spirit, that's a son of God. Because a regular heathen don't have that spirit. You just look in there, and they're like soulless almost. You look at him, it's just like just a retarded heathen.
Yeah, Bruce Lee made a lot of facial expressions.
Yeah.
A lot of
he's real.
That's only characteristic of us.
He was a philosopher, you know, he's going deep on deep spiritual level.
Check this out. This is Matthew 26:6. Now when Yehoshua was in Bethany in the house of Simon the leper. Now the Lord's around a leper. You know what a leper is, right?
Yeah.
People hanging around the Edomite.
Well, biblical leprosy is not what you think, like modern. There's many different types of leprosy, right. Okay. But yeah, like the scriptures talk about leprosy, some Israelites, we can get that Leviticus, we'll just read it to make it easier to understand. What's that, Leviticus 13 to 13? I didn't write that in a minute. I know it's 13, it's either 12 or 13. Let me look it up, see how I help you out. I know it's Leviticus. I think it is 13, it's 12 maybe. Yeah, that's it, 13 to 12. Yeah. You got it? I already got it. You want me to read it?
Boy, that's the play. 13 to 12. This is Leviticus 13 to 12. And if a leprosy break out of a roll in the skin, and the leprosy cover all the skin of him that had the plague from his head even to his foot, wheresoever the priest looketh,
Then the priest shall consider, and behold, if the leprosy have covered all his flesh, he shall pronounce him clean that hath the plague. It is all turned white. He is clean.
Appreciate it, fellas.
All right. What y'all doing out here?
We're doing security.
Oh, yeah? That's got to be an easy job, huh?
Not too bad. Better than my manual labor job.
Hell yeah. Fuck that shit. All right, bro. I would love to have a job like that, boy. Y'all got to be... Hell yeah, ride around on bikes, huh? I don't know why.
For some reason, they don't like to do nothing.
Hey, I'm trying to do nothing. I don't like working. Hey, that's another trait of Israelites. We don't like to work. Hell nah, bro. I thought that's what the heathens were for. You know what I mean? See, we like to work on things that we're passionate about, not do no menial-ass bullshit labor. You know what I mean? Actually, when it comes to things I like, I'm a workaholic. You know what I mean? I can't stop working. Like, working with this truth. Studying, I can't stop studying. I was up till damn 3 o'clock last night. Just studying, bro. What was I studying last night? I can't even remember. Some bugged out shit about some ancient Romans. I was studying this, the Sibylline books. You ever hear about that? I don't know, I'm saying it wrong, Sibylline books. It was some books, some written by some so-called prophetesses. But the Roman government used these books and these prophecies, and they used these pagan prophecies to dictate how that government ran. Just look it up, you know, it's bugged out. Yeah, you know, it was given by, you know, one of Apollo's oracles. some bugged out shit, man. But you see, the United States government is running exactly the same way the ancient Roman government was ran. That's why in ancient Rome, the Caesars were augurs, right? They was the head. Not only was they the head of the state, they was the head of the religion. Same thing in America. When a president becomes president, does he become inducted? No. Does he get hired? No, he becomes inaugurated. You know what an augur is, bro? An augur is a high priest of the Roman religion. And he receives omens and prophecies by watching the flight of birds. And that's why... That was Eddie Murphy? Was he an auger in that? And people don't know what an auger is. Inaugurated, they don't even know what that means. Yeah, Hey, just like Hillary Clinton, she's running for president right now, and everybody says she belongs in prison.
The criminal?
Yeah, the criminal. She passed out today with her old broke down ass. Yeah, she overheated. But Hillary admits it that she had a seance in the White House and she summoned up the spirit of Eleanor Roosevelt to help her out, to give her some guidance. You know what I mean? She's a witch. You can look at her. Listen to that laugh. That's one evil laugh, bro. Fucking creepy as hell. What was we going into? Oh, we gone. We done with that. Hit him with the Hulk Hogan leg drop.
What's that?
That's the Lord.
Oh, Wi-Fi?
We was talking about,
did anybody grab something?
We just talking about how, you know, about pretty much witches and warlocks control the government. That's why our president becomes inaugurated. They, you know, they become the high priest. Like, just like Julius Caesar, he was the augur. And that's how he became very popular with the people with that. Hey, you know, the Capitol Hill building in Washington, D.C., is named after Capitol Hill in ancient Rome. There's seven hills in ancient Rome, and one of the hills was called Capitoline Hill. And on top of that hill set the temple to Jupiter, the high god, you know, the top god of the Romans, right? So that's why the Capitol building looks like a, what is it? It's a temple. You see that building right here? The State House. That's a temple. It's a temple to Jupiter. You look at straight ahead down the alley, a city hall, that's a temple. And you can look at the doors, it's a temple. But look, I'm going to get the temple to Baal.
Read this real quick. This is Isaiah 47.
I was just about to get the same scripture.
Yeah, 13, right.
I was for real, look, I was right there, boy.
Thou art word in the multitude of thy counsels. Let now the astrologers, the stargazers, the monthly prognosticators stand up and save thee from these things that shall come upon thee.
Right, because they think they're going to prevail with their witchcraft, you know? Like Hillary thinking she's going to summon up some spirits to help her out. Ain't nothing going to help her this time around.
Damn. With the Most High about to do to America, they're tearing up his ass off.
For real.
And them devils, they're the source of the problem.
Yeah, that's the chief.
That's the head of the snake.
Yeah, that's the head of the snake, for real.
And their head is about to get chopped the fuck off. It's going to be in that pit. Let me finish reading this.
Oh, just like another one. Everybody was putting their trust in Bernie Sanders, the Jew. And then they all got shocked and surprised when he, endorsed Hillary Clinton. Like, he didn't know that was going to happen.
It was stupid.
That dumb as hell, bro. I'm talking about Phil to burn. Yeah, y'all ass got burnt. Bernie burnt your ass.
Behold, they shall be a stubble. That's funny.
That's the spirit. Behold, they shall be stubble. Phil to burn, baby.
The fire shall burn them. They shall not deliver themselves from the power of the flames. There shall not be a cold to warm them from fire.
Yeah, so when that fire consumes America, if you ain't right with the Most High, you ain't gonna make it. All y'all that done joined forces with Satan, y'all gonna get burned up. Everybody that came up against us and scoffed at the word, y'all gonna get burned up, man. That's an extra punishment.
The spirit don't play with the spirit. Thus shall they be unto thee with whom thou hast labored, even thy merchants from thy youth. They shall wander every one to his quarter. None shall save thee.
Hey, you want to scoot over here? Ain't nobody over here.
You straight?
Yeah. Did you read all of that?
Yep.
Oh, you sure did. Oh, it's really, you gotta read the whole chapter. It's like,
Let me read this. Name 3 and 4. No, I'm starting 1. 1 is down to 4. Woe to the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery. The prey departeth not.
Yeah, because America's the bloody city, all right?
The noise of a whip and the noise of the rattling of the wheel.
That's all you hear is just cars. In the ancient world, they had wagons and shit. Nowadays, they got cars. This shit noisy as hell out here, man. We be out here teaching sometimes. You watch the videos half the time. You can't hear what we saying because all the noise from the cars.
Fucking fire hires.
Yeah, the fire truck, loud-ass motorcycles. That's them wheels for them chariots. A car is nothing but a chariot. Even the word car comes from the same root word as chariot. The word chariot comes from the word to carry. The word car comes from the word to carry. So the word chariot and car are actually the same word. If you didn't know that, now you'll know. A chariot, a chariot, it's the same word.
In the prancing horses and of the jumping chariots, the horsemen lifted up both the bright sword and the glittering spear, and there is a multitude of slain and a great number of carcasses, and there is none end of their corpse. They stumble upon their corpse.
That's going to be beautiful, man. When that death and that destruction comes, it's going to be beautiful.
Hey, what's cracking?
Yeah, my Ruby boot, you got the wrong name.
Oh, my goodness. Well, she just blessed you, son. You got to...
She didn't say that.
She said, God bless you. Man, that's what, man.
She started back there.
That's some demons, man.
Yeah, that's what that is, too.
That's all right, man.
That's what we're doing with that crowd.
That's why you gotta come out here to curse some demons out, man.
She need home, man. She need knock the fuck out.
For real. And get Ray Rice. See, man, that right there, bro. I ain't gonna show it on camera, cause.
That's why the churches say they bonehead bitches, man. They're undisciplined. Let me read some more of this.
Our women have been totally spoiled, bro.
Look at the bulls in this little town. Those niggas eating the ass off. Niggas eating the ass off.
You know, back in the day, you might get stoned for doing that in public. You think back when Israel was in power? Do you think under the rule of King David, during the time of King David, what do you think would happen to a woman twerking on the street?
You saw what he said. Damn, his wife said something to him, just said something to him, and got put away. You know?
Yep.
Being out of the door, shit.
He locked her ass up.
Locked her ass up. In the rest of her life, she didn't have no kids or nothing, man.
Lord don't play. He ain't fucking around, man.
Put that bitch off the world. And then nobody come to her, man. Man, just look around, man. You know, literal man. You know? That's my sister. That was Saul's daughter, huh? Literal, come on, man.
So these people got held to
all the King David's business. Oh, come on, man. You know. She didn't mean it. Well, she should have known better, right? Because her mom and dad probably raised, you know, right? I mean, Saul, he knew what was going on. He knew that he taught that bitch right, man. You know?
But that's a straight spirit of Satan is out here.
Right.
Man. Satan got a hold of our people.
Got him. Because the multitude of thy whores of the well-favored world, the mistress of witchcrafts that selleth nations through her whores and families through her witchcraft.
And they do, they sell nations through whores and witchcraft. I mean, they literally sell nations. How do you think that them fake Jews got the land in Israel? That was part of a deal. Going back to leading up to World War I. Because, you know, the British prime minister, you know, he pretty much promised the Rothschilds that we're going to get the land for you. You know what I mean? We're going to get it. I promise.
What was that letter when he sent?
The Balfour Declaration. Yeah.
Behold, I am against thee, said the Lord of hosts, and I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness and thy kingdoms thy shame, and I will cast abominable filth upon thee, and make thee vile, and will set thee as a gazing stock.
Yeah, America's gonna get turned to a gazing stock. Oh, just like, was that Revelation? Was that 18 when it said, you know, all the merchants, whatever they mourned for, they from destruction? Everybody hits at him? Yeah, get that.
Dwell her and lament for her when they shall see the smoke of her burning. Then afar off with the fear of her torment, saying, alas, alas, that great city, Babylon, that mighty city, when 1 hour is thy judgment come.
Oh yeah, like the Saudi Arabians. That's one of America's biggest allies, not allies, but with money, you know what I mean? They make a lot, Saudi Arabia makes a lot of money off of America. That's probably where they make most of their money, right? So they're going to wail, and they're going to cry, and then they're going to go into slavery. Because all them Ishmaelites are going to be our slaves in the kingdom.
They have a bigger one right now,
too.
Yep. And plus the Senate, Congress has passed something against Saudi Arabia about 9/11, man. It's a false
story. Oh, yeah. Well, because, you know, more and more truths coming out against it. People want answers. So now they're trying to put the blame solely on Saudi Arabia now. Like it was, they was the ones behind it, you know what I mean? Because they ain't never going to mention Israel, or the so-called Israel.
Okay, so I got a question, because I actually have two black men in the presidency who speak of religion, right? So what is your view? Don't record me, neither, please. So what is your viewpoint on... Oh, but she was still a fan. Like, you know. So what is your viewpoint on mainstream America saying that Christianity was created basically as another shackle for African Americans?
Christianity was.
I'm sorry.
Well, it doesn't matter. You don't get to pick and choose, all right? I'm the one speaking, so I'm the one you got to listen to.
I would have addressed you.
Don't ignore him, bro. Nobody's talking to you. Yeah. All right, now you got to shut up.
Why are you angry?
Because you're disrespectful.
I'm not being disrespectful.
I asked someone a question. Why you want to ask this question?
I mean, I would have asked him too, but it's just a general question.
I'm a so-called white person.
I would have asked you too in your own time. I want to hear everybody's take.
Oh, now you want
to
hear questions.
I don't have an issue. I didn't come over here to try to make fun of what you're saying.
Go
ahead.
I said, how do you feel about mainstream media saying that Christianity is another form of a chaplain for African Americans?
Which is what I just told you, but you ignored.
What's your take?
I told you. I told you the same thing.
You interrupted him. That's why.
No, I was talking.
You know what religion means.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you what religion means in my opinion. Cause I didn't write a book, not a PhD, whatever. I've been a Christian since I've been about 6.5 years old. Big. Religion is
give me my opinion. We need your religion. All I want is just the meaning of the word itself. Every word.